Hi everyone, this is Kalyan Kumar and welcome to my channel Chemistry Tutorials. And we are doing a lot of videos in solid state and today we have part 8 of 10. In the previous one, we talked about voids, both octahedral and tetrahedral voids. And in part 8, we are going to look at certain more voids, different types of voids. And in this particular case, we are going to look at the radius of the cation and the radius of the anion, or you can say the radius of the smaller to the radius of the larger atom to occupy a certain void, and that we call as the radius ratio. So today we're going to talk about radius ratio in this particular video. Now let's understand what is radius ratio. Now radius ratio is the minimum radius ratio for various coordination numbers. Now what it means is, let's assume that the cation is smaller than the anion. Generally, they are so. Of course, there are certain anions which are larger, which are smaller than cations. But in general, cations are smaller than anions. So let's say we want to find out the minimum radius ratio of a smaller to the larger atom for various types of coordination numbers. Now, please understand, if I ask you this question, do you think there is a certain minimum radius of a small atom that is required so that it is able to touch two large, bigger atoms? Just think about it. One small atom touching two large atoms, is there any minimum requirement for that? The answer is no. Any small atom is capable of touching two anions. And of course, the anions would like to stay apart, so they'll be at 180 degree to each other. But the fact of the matter is that any small atom, any small ion would be able to touch any two large atoms or ions. But this is not true for when you want to touch three of them. Because what happens is, when three atoms come together, they'll come in the form of an equilateral triangle because they have to be equidistant. And the closest they can approach is when they touch each other. So when they touch each other, there's a void created in between them. And this void has a specific volume. If a cation is, or the smaller atom, is smaller than the space of the void, it will not be able to touch the three anions or the three larger atoms. It will simply fall into it. So what we're going to do is, we're going to measure the minimum radius ratio of smaller to the bigger atom for various coordination numbers. So let's start with coordination number 3. For coordination number 3, we have three large atoms or ions, and as I said, the closest they can come is when they are in contact with each other. Now here you will notice that this void has a specific volume, has a specific size. If you want a cation to fit into this, the smallest possible cation or a smaller atom that can fit into this would be like this. A cation which is smaller than this would simply pass through, fall through. So this is the minimum size of the smaller atom that is required to be able to touch three large atoms. Now remember, bigger than this, no issues. If the cation is bigger than this, only thing is the anions will get pushed out, they won't touch each other. So bigger size is not a problem. We are talking about the minimum radius ratio. There has to be a minimum value for this radius ratio to exist. So I join the centers and that becomes an equilateral triangle. 2RA, because this is RA, where RA represents anion radius. So RA plus RA, that is 2RA. 2RA and 2RA. So that's an equilateral triangle. Now I'm going to join the vertex of the triangle with the center of the cation. Vertex of the triangle with the center of the cation. And you can see that this is RC plus RA. This is RC, radius of the cation, and RA, radius of the anion. So this is RC plus RA. And this is a right angle triangle. And can you see it's an angle bisector, just like you've seen in many other cases. Equilateral triangle, join the center of the triangle with the vertex. It acts as an angle bisector, the angle is 30 degrees. So this is point O, this is point A, and this is point B, and the angle is 30 degrees. Now AB is RA. AB is RA, and AO or OA, as you might call it, is RC plus RA. So AO upon AB. Hypotenuse upon base is 1 by cos 30, that is secant 30, which is 2 by root 3. And AO is RC plus RA. And AB is RA. So from here, if I separate this, I get RC by RA plus RA by RA, which is 1. 1 goes here, it becomes minus 1. The RC by RA becomes 0.155, which means if you have a bigger atom, the smaller atom that can touch these three bigger atoms would have a radius of 0.155 times the radius of the anion. Only then this cation will be capable of touching these three anions. Otherwise, it will not be able to touch. Bigger radius ratio is not a problem. So cations with radius ratio less than 0.155 with respect to an anion can only have coordination number 2, because we know that for 2 there is no limitation. Cations with radius ratios more will be in contact with 3 anions, but the anions will not be in contact with each other. So this is the minimum value. So now let's go for coordination number 4. And in coordination number 4, let's take tetrahedron first. Coordination number 4, tetrahedron. Now we've already done using this in coordinates. If you remember when we did octahedral and tetrahedral word in the previous video, I used coordinates to make sure that you understand that the distances are equal between the atom in the void and the other atom that it is in contact with, as well as the angle of 109.5 degrees. So I'm going to create a tetrahedron. Tetrahedron is something like this, and this is a tetrahedral void. And we will use the cube and the coordinates to understand this part. Now remember FCC, and remember we know where the tetrahedral voids are. We know that it is a by 4 a by 4 a by 4, remember, a by 4 a by 4 a by 4. That is assuming this to be the origin. This will be x-axis, this is y-axis, this is z or z-axis, a by 2 a by 2 0. This guy is going to be 0, a by 2, a by 2, and this fellow is 0 on the x-axis, 0, a by 2, a by 2. So now what I'm going to do is, this is the origin. Now I'm going to assume they're all in contact. Can you see they're all in contact? Anions are all in contact. Only then you can get the minimum radius ratio. And the cation is in contact with this. And by using the distance formula, we know it's root 3, a by 4. This guy is root 3, a by 4. And since it is forming an FCC, because you're going to find this void in FCC and HCP. So in FCC, these three touch, the phase diagonal atoms touch, root 2a is 4r. This we already know in FCC. So I know the relationship between r and a. So I'm going to use that here. RC plus RA is root 3a by 4, distance formula. And 4RA is root 2a, because this is root 2a, and root 2a is RA plus 2RA plus RA. It's 4RA is root 2a. So RA is going to be, I'm substituting a from here, and I get root 3 by root 2. RC by RA becomes root 3 by root 2 minus 1, which is 0.225. So for an atom to have a tetrahedral void, it needs to grow up from the previous version of 0.155 to 0.225. So once it reaches 0.225, it can have a coordination number of 4 tetrahedron. Remember, it's not mandatory. Just because the radius is higher does not imply it will have a higher coordination number. It can even have a smaller one. But a smaller one cannot have a larger one if it is below the minimum value. So the minimum value for coordination number 4 tetrahedron is 0.225. Now let's go to coordination number 4 square planar or 6 octahedron. Now both of them have the same radius ratio. So let's see the square planar one. The anions are in the form of a square plane. Obviously these anions cannot touch. The diagonal ones cannot touch. And now look at how big the cation is. The cation has grown up now and is now able to touch 4 anions in the form of a square plane. And this is much more easier to deal with, because this is a square, 2RA. This is RC plus RA. And this is half of the diagonal. and the diagonal is root 2 A, where A is the length of the square. So it is root 2 2 RA. So 2 root 2 RA is the entire diagonal upon 2. So AO is RC plus RA, which is 2 RA by root 2, which is root 2 RA. And therefore, and we know that this from RC plus RA, now try to get this, RC plus RA is half of the diagonal. Diagonal is root 2 A, half of diagonal is root 2 A by 2, which is A by root 2, and A is 2 RA. So 2 RA by root 2, that is root 2 RA. Bring the RA down and you get RC by RA as 0.414, which means if I want to have the cation touching 4 anions in the form of a square planar shape, it must have a minimum radius ratio of 0.414. Lesser than that, it cannot touch a square planar 4 anions. Now, for the same radius ratio, you can even have an octahedron. That means if I place an atom on top of this, let's say something like this, now I can prove that this atom will also touch the top atom, which means if I can put something from the bottom, it will touch that also, which would give us an octahedron. Now, how do I prove this? That's pretty simple. The top atom is definitely going to touch the anions. So the top anion is definitely going to touch these anions because it is going to be placed on top of them. So if I join the center of the top sphere, now this is where you need to do a little bit of imagination. Center of the top sphere to this center, can you see? And then I join the center of the top sphere with the center of the cation, and then join these two, the center of the cation to the center of the anion, I get a right angle triangle. Now, what is the hypotenuse? That is the center of the top to the center of this. And since they are in contact, this circle is in contact with this, that will be 2RA. And we already know that this base, which is half of the diagonal, is root 2RA. So 2RA is the distance between the top anion and this anion, which is the hypotenuse. Base is root 2 RA. So what is the height? The center of the cation to the center of the top anion. That is also root 2 RA. Root 2 RA is the height. Root 2 RA is the base. That is why the hypotenuse is 2 RA. And if it is root 2 RA, then root 2 RA is RC plus RA, which means they are in contact. So the top anion is in contact with this cation, and so would be the bottom anion. Therefore, this radius ratio also works for 6 octahedron. Obviously, you cannot predict which one it will have. It will differ from case to case. Then we talk about coordination number 8. And that is a primitive unit cell of blue atoms. And right in the void center is the red one sitting. It looks like body centered. We don't call it body centered. We call it body centered type. Body centered can only be called if the middle one is also blue. Now, this is pretty simple again. The body diagonal, if you observe, body diagonal is root 3A. Root 3A will be 2RA plus 2RC, and A is 2RA. So, root 3A is 2RC plus 2RA, that is the body diagonal, and A is 2RA. Substitute the value of A, and you will get RC by RA as 0.732. So here the anion has grown up to 0.732. That means if the radius ratio is 0.732, only then a cation or a smaller atom can coordinate with 8 bigger atoms in the form of a cubic void. So that is the minimum coordination number for 8, the radius ratio. And now let's look at a table here. And please do subscribe to this channel in case you haven't done already. It is your encouragement that makes this channel work. It is your encouragement that makes me make more and more videos. In case you like the video, please do hit the like button too. And here is the table that is going to tell us everything. Radius ratio, coordination number. If the radius ratio is less than 0.155, we already know the coordination number is going to be 2. radius ratio is between these two. Remember, this is closed interval and this is open interval. So 0.225 is not included here. 0.155 is. Excuse me. Now the radius ratio, and now the coordination number in this case is going to be either 2 or 3. And between 0.225 and 0.414 open interval is going to be 2, 3 or 4 tetrahedron. And 0.414 to 0.732 open, 2, 3, 4 tetrahedron, 4 square planar, 4 or 6 octahedron. And 0.732 to 1, that's the maximum limit, you're going to have coordination number 8 also. So that's the deal with radius ratios. Again, let me reiterate, in case you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe to this channel. And if you have any comments, queries, questions, doubts, anything that you would like to talk about, please drop them in the comment section below. And please like the video, in case, hit the like button in case you like the video. And this is Kalyan Kumar signing off. Have a great day and thank you for watching.